You've offered me enormous deformities while forming me. Beyond abysmal diction dysmorphia, see, you had my soul in gore, see how scorched my endorphins be. You didn't count how profound or pronounce my abounding force would be. It's my semantics and antics of sorcery. So a proposed pose composed to be sewn and woven awesomely. I cry and moan yet remain sane morally. With anger and rage I was once engaged in my heart's darkness had grown enormously. And imparted the darkened heart of enormity, but became vacuous, even fatuous, purportedly. Emotions of loathing and disdain remained horridly, hurting me much more horribly, and yet letting go was seemed to be affordably, and it afforded me to try it, and like I did nonconformity. So I'm more mellow as my soul bellowed and left behind much coarse debris, because my perceptual flaws were on course to force me into the hands of authority, as my old path of wrath had burned me to the fourth degree. Now I take pills of peace orally, remaining sane in this mundane plane, and offer myself cordially, enjoying this existence, because I see Gaia's beauty as a scene that's seen gorgeously, and I feel precious presence has never lessened, and I'm effectively expressing my lesson sonorously, and it's a part of my heart's catharsis, I grew to harness the darkness cautiously. So now I'm forcibly endorsing me. I'm not endorsing force, but morphing into a mega force like a red dwarf coursing me. Which is why, of course, I bleed. And my mental glossary continues to sift and sit through as I spit through sinews and flip views remorsefully. But now I gotta exit this perplexed wit, as my next wit shall be my nexus. So open your third eye, but first relax your solar plexus.